All right, and then what are you drinking during the day?
Soda pops.
Okay. And how much do you think you drink a day?
8 to 12 a day.
New research on Americans 65 and older links drinking diet soda to a rise in abdominal obesity.
What's incredible is that the average American is drinking 45 gallons of pop every year.
One study found that people who drank at least 2 sugar-sweetened soft drinks a day had a higher risk of death.
In total, that's 375 pounds of pop that passed through your system in 365 days. Even crazier is the sugar. 45 gallons of pop totals roughly 470 cans. In terms of sugar, that's 1,222 tablespoons of sugar, or 3 1/2 of these 10-pound bags. Now, at the end of this video, I'm going to give you a recipe for a soda you can make inexpensively at home that's actually healthy for you, and I'll show you it backed up by a study. That's if you decide none of these colas are right for you. If you doubt what I'm saying, then surely you see this at the grocery store. Piles of soda exactly at the front when you walk in. Yes, it's the first thing that you see. It's no wonder that a lot of people think about switching from regular Coke to Diet Coke or Coke Zero. With the sugar, the rush of sweetness activates the same reward centers in the brain as drugs. In fact, sugar is a drug, and it's the most popular drug in North America. It triggers the release of a brain chemical called dopamine in a known region called the nucleus accumbens. And as a result, we feel euphoria. The nucleus accumbens is considered as the neural interface between motivation and action, playing a key role on feeding, sexual reward, stress, drug self-administration behaviors, and more. Now we can see then, with all of that marketing, a Diet Coke or a Coke Zero becomes possibly more appealing. Look at this commercial from 1961 from regular Coke. This is fascinating. Let's watch.
You know, this was me 5 years ago, and it's still me. As I confess, I'm a waistline watcher from way back. Well, that's enough for today. Now for a lively lift. Ice cold Coca-Cola. There's no waistline worry with Coke, you know. Actually, this individual-sized bottle has no more calories than half a grapefruit. Mmm, another thing, the cold, crisp taste of Coke is so satisfying, it keeps me from eating something else that might really add those pounds. Coke's a natural, wholesome blending of pure food flavors. I guess that's why everyone likes the refreshing new feeling you get, only from not-too-sweet Coca-Cola. And no wonder, lively, lifty Coca-Cola provides a welcome bit of quick energy between meals. Makes for a pleasant pause in a busy day. Oh, and remember, Coke is low in calories, too. Say, now, don't you get any thinner.
Now let's look at a Coke Zero commercial.
I need to try it first.
You see, no sugar, no calories. Is it really that simple, though? Which one is really better for your health? You even often hear people drinking Coke Zero or Diet Cola in an attempt to lose weight. But does this really work? And by the way, for those wondering the difference between Diet Coke and Coke Zero, well, it's the taste. Both of these drinks are sugar-free and calorie-free. Coca-Cola Zero Sugar looks and tastes more like Coca-Cola original taste. That's why it was brought on the market. While Diet Coke has a different blend of flavors, which gives it more of a lighter taste. Diet Coke came on the market in 82 and Coke Zero came in 85. Let's talk about the differences between these two drinks. First of all, regular Coca-Cola. It's a classic soda that's been around since 1886. Coca-Cola was originally marketed as a medicinal drink that could cure a range of ailments, from headache to impotence even. It's made with high fructose corn syrup and has 140 calories, 39 grams of sugar per can, and that's about 2.6 tablespoons of sugar content. The only calories in regular Coca-Cola come from sugar. There's no other dietary value. Let's look at the label.
You can see a serving size is one container. There's 140 calories. course, zero fat, some sodium, some carbohydrates. Look at the sugars. There's your 39 grams right there. And now if you look down here, what's in it? Carbonated water, high fructose corn syrup, caramel color, phosphoric acid, natural flavors, and of course, caffeine, which is another addictive substance, is why people drink it. So you got the caffeine here and your sugar there.
Now, Coke Zero. It was created after market research showed that men were less likely to drink diet soda because they perceived it as what? Too feminine. So let's look at the label of Coke Zero.
Now, if we look at our Coke Zero, here we are, one can is a serving size, fat zero, sodium 2% again. If we look, added sugars, here's the key, 0%. But when we go, let's remove these marks, and we go and look, here's your ingredients here. You got carbonated water, you have your color, caramel color. Here's your phosphoric acid, and look at your aspartame here. But it's not just your aspartame, because if we come down and look, there's also the citrate acesulfame, and of course, caffeine. So there's the biggest difference is zero sugars. The big draw, of course, look, zero calories.
There is a difference on the label between Diet Coke and Coke Zero for you Diet Coke drinkers out there. I'll note this, the sweeteners are a little bit different. While Diet Coke uses aspartame as its sweetening agent, Coke Zero uses both aspartame and acesulfame. That sounds better than the 10-pound bags of sugar, right? Or is it? Well, here is the issue with Coke Zero. Number one, unfortunately, Coke Zero has, well, zero nutritional value as well. And aspartame has been shown to contribute to depression and irritability. Look at this study.
Okay, check this important study, the effects of aspartame consumption on mood and depression. This was a study, and remember, a lot of people take Coke, Diet Coke, Coke Zero for the upper, and they think it makes their mood better. And while a caffeine can, look at what aspartame does. Participants were significantly more depressed after they consumed the high aspartame diet compared to when they consumed the low aspartame diet. After consuming the high aspartame diet, 3 of the 28% participants had a depression score of over 49, indicating mild to moderate clinical depression. That is huge. So after consuming the low aspartame diet, all 28% participants had depression scale scores within the normal range. So then if you had the lower diet, the better you did, meaning there is a dose response curve here. The participant scores on Zung's irritability subscale showed significant more irritability after consuming the high aspartame diet. So it's not just the depression, but irritability. And of course that affects your life and of course everyone around you.
Number two, you are tricking your body and your dopamine because you're eating something sweet. You see, this increases your insulin and decreases your glucagon, and that's the opposite of what you want. You see, your body feels like you're gonna have something sweet, so it adjusts the hormones to digest the sugar. This is exactly the opposite of what you want for fat burning. So if you're using these for diet or Coke Zero for fat burning, therein lies the problem. Number three, several studies have indicated that diet sodas may increase appetite stimulating hormones such as ghrelin, therefore increasing your hunger. Number four, the artificial sweeteners in Diet Coke may also alter the gut flora, and that leads to reduced blood sugar control. The gut biome is very important. Number five, additives such as citric acid, malic acid, and phosphorus acid. They're present in both Coke, Coke Zero, and Diet Coke, and they've been linked to tooth erosion. Number six, some research has also linked diet sodas to health conditions such as increased risk of high blood pressure, osteoporosis, and heart and kidney disease. Now, it's not all negative. I've been able to tease out some positives for you. For example, both sodas contain caffeine. This can boost your energy levels and improve mental alertness, similar with coffee. Now, there are healthier choices to get your caffeine, but there is caffeine in here. Additionally, studies have shown that phosphoric acid in Coca-Cola can help prevent kidney stones. So there is something positive to hang your hat on if indeed you are addicted, like many of us are. So which one should you choose? Well, ultimately it comes down to personal preference and what you are looking for in a soda. If you're watching your calorie intake or you have diabetes, Coke Zero is a better choice since it has zero calories and zero sugar. I think overall that's the one I'd rather see you drink. However, if you're looking to avoid artificial sweeteners, Coca-Cola may be the way to go. You got to accept the sugar, but then you're not getting the problems with artificial flavoring. Often, for most people, the reason they're drinking these is hydration and the feeling of dehydration and, most importantly, the sugar crave, the addiction, the dopamine release from the brain. It is clear that there are negative aspects to both diet and regular Coke, so my alternative is soda water with a splash of pomegranate juice. You see, pomegranate juice has resveratrol. According to a recent study, drinking as little as 2 ounces of pomegranate juice per day has shown to lower blood pressure, improve cholesterol, and cleanse plaque from arteries, a key one, number one killer in the world, heart disease. These are all good news for your heart. This study, this particular one, goes on to suggest that pomegranate juice may be a prudent to add to heart healthy diets. The soda water that I'm telling you to mix it with satisfies that need for the fizz or the carbonation. So what you want to take is about a 1/3 to 2/3 ratio in a large cup, a third of pomegranate juice, and then mix the rest with soda water. And you can kind of adjust it to taste, but it solves that craving for that little bit of sugar, the flavoring, the carbonation, and the fizz. It's a much healthier choice. And I think even just gradually making that switch can be huge for people. If you've enjoyed this video, click on this video all about supplements and things you can do to keep your body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.